The net execution time calculates only the time that a task was actually running. In this example, this means we have three different phases where the task is running. So this one, and here in the end. And this adds up to the net execution time. So the net execution time is really only the time that a task is running and is not influenced by any start delays or by any preemptions. If you want to set up the net execution time as a requirement in the Timing Architect tool suite, you can go to the base part of the tool and select there the requirements editor, and you will get a picture like this. Here, you first of all need to select the process. In this example, the 1 millisecond task. You need to search for the metric, the net execution time. You can now select different limits. In this case, we will go for the upper limit of the net execution time. And you can select different severity levels. In this example, critical, major, and minor. Let's now have a look at the net execution time in the TA tool suite. First of all, here you can see the Gantt chart, which shows you the state transitions of the different tasks that are running in your system based on the different cores that they are running on. Here below in the process table, you can currently see the net execution times of the task 1 milliseconds. And you can see that on average it was running for 0.47 milliseconds and the minimum was 4.1 and the maximum 0.52 milliseconds. We will now switch to the requirements table where we can find the three requirements that we have defined earlier on. We can see that it's always a requirement on the net execution time of the task 1 millisecond, and it considers the limit 0.5, 0.6, and 0.7 milliseconds as minor, major, and critical requirements violations. If you now drag and drop this violated requirement into the Gantt chart, you can see that the Gantt chart is visualizing the requirements violations with a red arrow. So you now have the possibility to scroll around in the Gantt chart and find the violations. Additionally, you can also use a histogram by dragging and dropping also the requirement into the histogram. And you can now see the distribution of the net execution time of the task 1 millisecond across the measurement. Everything here on the left side did not violate the requirement. Every instance here on the right side did violate this requirement. If you want to deep dive now and analyze what happened here in these violations, you can simply mark the instances that you're interested in. You click right and you can send them to the clipboard. Now you have the possibility to double click on the different violations, and you will always jump to the point in the Gantt chart where this violation happened. At the end of this video, I want to offer you some possibilities to stay in touch and find out more about timing analysis. For that, I'm inviting you to join the LinkedIn group Runtime Analysis in AutoSAR Projects. In this group, you will meet other people working in this field, sharing their experiences and solutions for this topic. And you will, of course, also be able to engage in discussions and ask your questions there. Just search for the group directly on LinkedIn. Or if you want to have it easier, I put a QR code here in the video so you can simply scan the QR code and you will be redirected to this group. Would be happy to have you in the group. If you have questions to me directly or if you want to connect with me, I'm inviting you to scan the QR code here on the right. You can also see the link to my profile here on LinkedIn. I would be very happy to connect with you and answer any questions you have. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm looking forward to stay in touch with you.